my double blade axe and my hobnail boots, I go where the timber's tall. When there's work to be done, don't mess around, just sing right out for Paul.
Hey, Paul!
I'm coming, boys!
Paul Bunyan!
Paul Bunyan! He's 63 axe handles high, with his feet on the ground and his head in the sky. Hey, Paul!
Welcome to Rasmussen-Bates Saws. Today, we're looking at a Poulan Pro 42cc chainsaw. A friend of mine brought this in with the complaint that it would stall once it gets running. After reviewing all the blogs, repair blogs online, and reviewing a lot of YouTube videos, this is a very common problem for this saw. So, I'm sure if you're looking at this video trying to make sense of this issue, I'm going to give you a lot of good information you're not going to see on any of the blogs and any of the videos that I've seen and I'm encountering with this saw. You know, first off, if you are someone who just likes to cut some branches every once in a while, maybe once or twice a year, you might need a chainsaw. This is probably a pretty good idea for you. You know, it's an off-market chainsaw. A lot of people enjoy them and they use them a lot harder here or there. It's just like anything. A cheaper model of whatever you buy is going to have these type of issues. I highly suggest, obviously, steel. It's a family tradition. My grandfather used steel. I'll keep it on that family tradition. The only other mainstream saw out there that you could possibly consider is Husqvarna. But with that said, there's a lot of common problems that seem to work for a lot of people, but this particular saw is a little different, I think. But we'll go over those simple problems that you might want to look at. First off is the spark gap. Was noted in many different places that the gap is really low on the stock spark plug. And a lot of the suggestions were 2500ths to 30,000ths. I adjusted this just over 25,000ths. I didn't see much of a difference when I was adjusting everything, so that wasn't the problem for me. I did change out the carburetor, and take note on what I'm about to say next, because you're not going to see this anywhere else on any of the blogs and any of the videos. They never talked about setting the high and low set screws. Typically on steels, Husqvarnas, there's a typical starting point that you can start with those saws and work from there. Everything I was reading on this was you're just going to have to figure it out yourself. Even the manual, I reviewed the manual and it didn't give a specific starting point. So I want to make note of the original carburetor that came in and where it was adjusted. And that's not to say that the customer had it made prior adjustments coming in that maybe offset the stock. But anyways, these are the notes that I have. So on the low, when I checked the low on the stock carburetor, the low was turned out 3 turns. The high was turned out 2.5 turns. On the new carburetor, when it came in this box, I checked it and it had a 1.5 turnout on the low and a 0.5 turnout on the high. I put the new carburetor on. It still didn't want to start correctly, and with my adjustments with the new carburetor, I had 2.5 turnouts on the low and a 3/4 turnout on the high. And that seems really lean, but that's what the saw was running the best at. And when you're the high, you notice you just rev that thing as to the max, and you sit there with the adjusting screw. And when the engine revs to its highest RPMs, you just back off 1/4 of a turn. Maybe, and that's about mid-range for a saw on any tuning. And that's what I got, 3/4. Knowing that that's a little low, that might lead into the next thing I want to talk about that's possibly wrong with this chainsaw. And it's really sad. This chainsaw seems like it only has a couple hours of use, and then it just sat on somebody's shelf for the last decade. Super clean. When I would check the spark plug, it was really wet inside the cylinder, and that's a big indication of just flooding, and that's what I was assuming was happening at first. But on further looking and feeling, when I felt inside the spark plug hole, pulled my finger out, the wetness was kind of gray, kind of a graphite feel, and that's an indication of engine failure. Also looking at the cylinder walls, there was a lot of lines and what we call scoring. Also, when I took off the muffler, looking at the exhaust port, they look like there's some chips of metal where the piston meets the cylinder wall that possibly might be due to overheating and the metal just failing and causing that to rub off of the engine. A little later in the video, I will take pictures of what the inside of the cylinder looks like currently with this saw. Unfortunately, I wish I would have got pictures of what it looked like when I first looked at it with all the flooding and the gunk buildup that I'm assuming is the metal. Because once I put the new carburetor on and I tuned it just right, it really cleaned out the saw, and now it looks pretty clean other than what you're going to see later in the scarring. This is a 066 cylinder that I took off one of my old steel saws. It was a used steel 066, and the story I get was a used forestry saw because it was painted green. And so I'm assuming that there's at least 300 to 600 hours on this particular cylinder. So the cylinder, the engine didn't really have any problems for me to change it out. I just wanted the oversized cylinder head. So I put an oversized engine kit that you can buy for steels on this particular saw, and it runs just as good, just as strong. Again, the cylinder, nothing wrong with it. It's just a stock cylinder that we'll compare with later. So next I'm gonna go outside, set the video up, and run this saw. It's been sitting overnight, so it eliminates possibilities of flooding. Everything has a full tank of gas. Like I said, I've done all the repairs I could possibly think of to the saw to run right. So we'll see what happens, and then if it stalls out again, we'll obviously, we're gonna check the cylinder, and I'm gonna show you what I'm assuming the problem is. So again, yes, spark plug gap, possible carburetor issues, possibly coil failure. That you could throw a lot of money at this particular saw to hopefully fix this problem. But at the end of the day, if I have to change the cylinder, I'm gonna recommend just getting a different saw. Again, where I live, I'm at 3,200 feet, so take note of that on my carburetor adjustment. But around here, most people use wood as their main source of heat. So you really need a good and reliable saw, which I recommend to be steel. So anyways, I'll talk to you in a little bit. Running pretty good, so possibly it was a fuel issue, but ultimately this is the final test. I ran it pretty good up to operating temperature. As you see, I cut through a piece of oak about 6 inches in diameter, an old piece of cedar. So hopefully it starts up next. This is the ultimate test. This is where it gets kind of tricky, right? So it should have started up right away. It's well warmed up. And this is where a lot of the problems happen. Start choking it again. Possibly gonna get into flooding.
but we'll see what happens. Toe to hold the throttle, and you can see it wanted to cough a few times. Yeah, I really don't want to start choking anymore. It's going to get into flooding. But still have the problem. My only suggestion is run it, see how long you can run it, and just don't turn it off. Set it back on the shelf, and then for the next time for the little job, but other than that, just throw in the trash, just ain't worth it.
Well, it's about 15-20 minutes since we ran this outside. I'm gonna go ahead and take off the top, and I'm gonna show you what I think is possibly wrong with this, and that has to do with the scoring on the cylinder head and so forth. I get some tools here. I noticed that some of these Poulans have flatheads, but then this particular one has a star. It's a T20. I guess you put a flathead in there, but it's still a T20. Looks like it's going to be a little messed up. I'm going to put the brake on this one to get this off. Lift up a little bit. It goes on and off. Kind of funky. So, this is the probably the original filter that came in. It was battery. I watched it out a little bit. As you can see, it's not bad at all. The newer ones that came in the kit were slightly bigger, so they didn't want to quite fit in the... It's thicker. It's one of the problems. It's just a slight hair wire on all the edges. It doesn't want to fit in there. Not snug. The plastic clips. It's all only held on by plastic clips. Really cheesy. And as you can see, when I was taking it off, it was falling off already. One of the things I was talking about earlier is that the new carburetor that came in had a different adjustment or linkage right here. So you can see this linkage is really nice, really nicely thought out. This particular linkage, I just had to bend back this bar here, because it wasn't like, it was sliding back and forth and it wasn't engaging. So it's kind of funny that I had to bend that back, it wasn't set right or something. That's probably the biggest bigger problem I had with this carburetor on the aftermarket, most likely. The original carburetor, I think, stock's always better. Anybody's gonna tell you, just because the linkage, I really hated that right there, but we'll leave it as is, get back to customer. One of the other things I did too, I did replace the fuel filter lines in the tank. So you see, this filter wasn't bad at all. I noticed a lot of white stuff in the tank, so this filter was, like, falling apart, but again, that wasn't gonna be detrimental. When I did take the original carburetor apart and cleaned it, I only noticed some junk on the, on a carburetor screen that's embedded in the carburetor. There was some material, like rocks or something. I don't know how it got in there, because I'm looking at how the fuel flowed in and out, and how big it was. It seemed like it must have been just like a buildup of some sort, because it couldn't have gone in there any other way. But even cleaning that, you know, I cleaned out the carburetor, put it back on, and still was the same problem, unfortunately. And so I put back on the new carburetor that seemed to do well. As you can see, when we did a test out there, it ran really well. It didn't manage to start up, and we get on our way. And the engine's still a little warm. Be careful when you put these spark plugs on and off when it's warm, it won't be causing any more damage from your strip. As you see, the spark plug is not bad. Pretty normal. This was the original. The original was a slightly more burnt, and this is the new one we put in, and I've only ran it maybe 5-10 minutes. So as you can see, not a lot of difference there. Now, at this point, get the cylinder at its lowest point. Possibly I'll bring the foam down. Kind of hopefully we can see inside the cylinder I'm looking at here. And that gray buildup is back. So again, I'm pretty sure that might be the problem. Engine failure. You get this, like, I don't know if you can see that. It looks like dark stuff. Yeah, it's probably not a great example. Once we get the muffler off, my finger in there again, hopefully you'll see that that gray stuff I'm talking about. At this point, through the camera, see if we can look down inside this hole, the light, and hopefully you can see the back wall scarring somehow. Yeah. Okay, you can kind of see a lot of lines back there. Hopefully you see what I'm seeing. I do have a camera for this type of work, but I've only tried it once or twice. No, it's just gonna remain dark. My best example is right about here. Get where that light is. Looking in there, you're just gonna see a lot of lines and scarring in the back. Yeah, that's a pretty good shot right there. Now, let's talk about this other cylinder here. It came off my 066. Like I said, it was just used, but wasn't bad by any means. Get this right in the right light, possibly. But you got a pretty good mirror shine going on here. That's not bad. Yeah, that's a pretty good shot. This is a normal used cylinder. I'm assuming 600, 800 hours. I can't remember that. It was it's an 066, so that's a late model 90s. Not bad. Like I said, there's nothing wrong with it. I just wanted a bigger cylinder. And the edges are pretty clean. So the next thing is the muffler. We have a 10mm bolt on the outside. And where's my 10mm? I still don't know. Not too bad, it's warm. This bolt is really hard not to strip. Really gotta get in there. Make sure you're on your own way. Even then, it's really pushable. I was the first one to take this off, and even do my best to get a little strips right there. I didn't put it back on the spark arrestor.
Yes, I'm bad. Just, there's other people with common issues that these things clog up, and that was causing so much stalling problems. So again, these things just almost like new.
Right.
All this black stuff was there when I was stalking in. I was from the overflame. It's actually a lot cleaner now that I ran a few minutes. It's just the saw is so clean, got everything inside the sink. Clean. Really, really surprising to see something like this. Even though I'm not obviously a Poulan fan, I am a mechanical fan per se. A couple things here, obviously a gasket, heat shield. Everything looks like practically brand new. I'm gonna try and keep these things together in both holes that came out of. Put that back there for now. Alright. So, let's see if you can see what I'm seeing. Not really, I'm gonna take the phone off. But what I do wanna do, see this right here. And that's exactly what I'm talking about. This right here. This is just not gas and oil, this is gray. Like graphite, it's just engine breakdown. If it was black and oily, then that would be from the flooding. But this is purely metal sludge that's causing that. Just like I said, like a graphite type of feel. Hopefully, the camera you'll be able to see one of the major issues that I saw in the saw. I'm looking in the exhaust. Get down to a certain point here. I'm reviewing my light. See if I can shine some light on what I'm talking about. Bear with me. Almost. You can kind of see, even though it's blurry, that those shiny, yeah, see where it's real shiny there in the middle where the piston is? I mean, those are deep gouges. And right there at the edge, if I can just get the right corner, I don't know if it doesn't seem like you can see it with the camera, almost, like right there where the piston meets the edge of the cylinder, there's like chunks of metal missing, like 1, 2, and 3, which is very concerning. And see if we can look at the back of the wall, cylinder wall. No, it doesn't look like we're going to get a good shot, but you can totally tell what I'm talking about when you look at that piston. All those grooves right there. It's just really, really nasty. So, my assumption, when this thing heats up, it's losing a lot of compression, and then that's why I'm not able to start and saw this particular saw up again.
Someone did say something about venting of the cap, possibly when it warms up, and I don't really understand. I guess it's a one-way valve, so the gas will come out. What I could do is I could go blow this with the air, see if that helps. The only possible hole might be here in the center. I'm seeing something that might possibly be there, so I'm going to blow that out real quick.
Hard to say.
Let's do finger tight. Couple pumps. Stops down on this. Goes up. Well, it's probably still warm. That's one thing I didn't like about this new carburetor. It was super stiff on the choke. But slow it is. Let's see if I can get a pop out of this. We'll pop there. I don't know if that's good enough. Nothing. It's a little warm. Didn't think it was that hot. Alright, I'm not gonna kill myself anymore. Buy a steel. Thing I can suggest.